following with John Hill.
I'll
be thy name. I came to come. I will be done on
earth.
As it is in heaven.
Give us this day.
Our daily bread.
Give us our debt.
Give our debt to us.
Lead us not
to temptation.
Give us
me.
Thy
kingdom.
And the power.
And the glory.
Let him be unjust still. And he which is filthy, let him be filthy still. And he that is righteous, let him be righteous still. And he that is holy, let him be holy still. And behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to get every man according as his work shall be.
Lord, coming quickly. It don't matter what you're doing now, it's up to you what you're going to do once you get baptized. Whatever you're doing when he comes back, that's what you're going to be doing when he comes back. It's just as simple. Ain't no ad or taking to the book. He just says, he that is unjust, let him be unjust. If you feel that you're filthy. You know what I'm saying? You're righteous, you're righteous. And if you're holy, you're holy. But see, this is part of the covenant of the Baptist way, man.
I'm Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, first and the last. Blessed are they that do his command, that they may have right to the tree of life, and may enter in through the gates into the city.
Right to the tree of life. That's why you're here. You want access back to the tree of life. You know what I mean? So that's what we're here. Now let's go to, it's the opening right there. We're going to go to Romans 3 and 23. It's going to talk about the remission. Romans 3 and 23. Now this couple of verses, we're going to talk about the remission of sin and the baptism. That's what pretty much it is. So go ahead and do Romans 3 and 23, Matt.
All have sinned and come short of the glory
that's
of God.
Right. Uh-huh.
Being justified freely by his grace, through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus.
See, we all sinned and came short. That's why we got to get baptized. The redemption means to be saved, to be redeemed. So Jesus had to die to redeem us back to the tree of life. Go ahead, Matthew.
And God has set forth to be a propitiation through faith
in
his blood, to declare his righteousness for the remission of sins that are passed through the forbearance of God.
So he redeemed us. Now we got remission of sin. That means cancellation, free of debt, void. You know what I'm saying? That's remission. So he died with his blood to give you back remission to be redeemed back to the tree of life. Y'all understand it? All right. Now, with that being said, we're going to go to, that way you can understand that, we go to Romans 6. And this is just pretty much the baptism. Which one's going to be the baptism? Romans 6 and 1. Everybody know 1 and 2, but we're going to go over it anyway. So go ahead, brother Matt.
What shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin? Grace may abound,
all be. All
right. How shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein?
And so you put off the grace. And we all know that's part of the covenant. You got to keep the Sabbath day holy. You know what I'm saying? You got to keep the dietary law. You know what I mean? You got to do all these things and then get baptized in the name of Jesus. Keep the Sabbath day holy. You know what I mean? That's when grace come in. Not no time sooner. You ain't getting no grace. Go ahead, man. Now, three is a key. Go ahead, man.
Know ye not that so many of us have been baptized into Jesus Christ, baptized into his death?
So you're getting baptized into his death. So when you get through reading 6, don't get confused. He's talking about baptism into his death. You understand what I'm saying? So this ain't the first resurrection you flying off. This is talking about dying. Your old self is dying. So as we read chapter 6, you understand when he's talking about getting baptized or dying or death or whatever, he's talking about the baptism. Okay? Go ahead, man.
Therefore, we are buried with him by baptism into death.
We buried with him. We redeemed. You understand? So he redeemed us after we died. Now, go ahead.
That like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father,
that's right,
even so we should walk in newness of life.
Oh, so we redeemed. That's us being redeemed, right?
Yes, sir.
And then the remission was our past sins. Now we got to walk in the newness of life. You understand what I'm saying? So go ahead, man.
When we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, we should also be in the likeness of his resurrection.
So death meaning the baptism, the resurrection meaning putting on your new body. Let's go ahead, six.
Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, and henceforth we should not serve sin.
So the whole body, so when you die, we get baptized in death. That's what I mean by die. So when y'all go in this water, the old body, the old you is gone. You know what I mean? You can't do what you used to do. You know what I mean? This is more serious now. You know what I'm saying? So you under the covenant now. You know what I mean? So I was going to read 7 and 8 and 9, but we'll skip that and just go straight to 10.
10?
Yeah.
When that he died unto sin once. When that he liveth unto God.
So he died once, so the Jesus ain't going to keep going back to the cross and being crucified for you. He died once, that's it. And, well, let's go back to the cross. Let's die again.
No.
And that ain't going to happen. So he just doing it once, so you're going to get baptized once. So sin no more. You know what I mean? I ain't talking about you fall, you got to get back up. Because if you stay down, you're reprobate, ain't you?
Right.
So you got to get back up. And that's when grace come in. I was talking about in verse 1 and 2. You understand?
All right.
All right, let's go to verse 20.
Verse 20. When you were the servants of sin, you were free from righteousness.
Oh, so when you served sin, you was free from righteousness.
Right.
So sin felt good, so you was free from being, you know, in the truth. But now, since you know, go ahead and read 21.
What fruit had ye then in those things whereof ye are now ashamed?
22.
For the end of those things is death.
Right.
But now being made free from sin and become servants to God, ye have your fruit unto holiness and the end everlasting life.
Oh, so now you're the fruit.
Yes, sir.
So you're going for the first resurrection. Now, Jesus being the Pentecost, Jesus being what? The first fruit.
Mm-hmm.
You see, he the first fruit that went up to the Father. Now, you're going to be the first fruit at his coming. That's why it's so important this covenant be together. And you come together in this covenant. You know what I mean? So, with that being said, we're just going to go over a couple of verses. Brother Marlon went over some today. Let's go to Acts 4. By Jesus.
Yes.
Yeah, Acts 4 and 10. In Jesus' name. That's why we baptize in Jesus' name. That's just letting you know. And I did want to go back and read that. Well, let's go. Here. Jesus, I mean, Acts 4, 10 and 12. Acts 4, yeah, I'm ready.
Be it known unto you all and to all the people of Israel that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom ye crucified, whom God raised from the dead, even by him, do this man stand here before you whole. This is the stone which was set in naught of you builders, which has become the head of the cone.
This is the God we worship today. He the Son, he's the God. And everybody know that's been in the truth. Now go ahead, 3:12.
Neither the salvation in any other name.
Ain't no salvation. So you can't even come in this covenant without saying in Jesus' name. Ain't no salvation in any other name. Like Brother Marlon said, Yahshua, Yahweh, not all the mother ones. If you from another place, you can use that name if it means Jesus. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
For there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved.
Ain't no other name given among heaven that you must be saved. That's the name of Jesus, right? All right, we're going to skip Philippians. Well, we're going to go to Philippians.
So Philippians?
Yeah.
All right, we got to line up.
Philippians 2. 5 through 11.
No, I need that.
That song be.
I read it.
I'm weaving, trying to box, but he kept knocking it to the back.
I read it as soon as I get there, people.
Yeah.
I read it.
I was saying, Lord, please blow on me a little bit. Philippians 2, 5. We're going to read 5 through 11. Go ahead.
Okay. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God.
He said, I've been in the form of God. Thought it not robbery to be equal with God. Because they both God beings, the Godhead. You understand? Go ahead, bro.
But made himself of no reputation and took upon him the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of men.
By him coming in the flesh, go ahead.
And being found in the fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross.
That's what you got to do. You humble yourself. You know what I'm saying? You get baptized, the old you die, and you got to stay humble. Fall, get back up. It's going to be a fight. Satan coming.
Exactly.
He's swinging today, ain't he?
Yes,
but see, he coming. And you better believe that. You know what I mean? But see, you under that grace now. You're under that grace period. And you're under the Lord's hedges. You know what I'm saying? So he going to chase you. You know what I mean? He going to send you the comfort and be over you. You know what I'm saying? So now you, Romans 8:31, if God be for you, who can be against you? You understand what I'm saying? So this is something you need to do. Go ahead, brother.
Wherefore God also had highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name.
And there it go again, same thing, a name above every name, go ahead.
That at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow.
Yes, sir.
Of things in heaven and things in earth,
yeah,
and things under the earth. And that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of the God the Father.
Yes, sir. And that's pretty self-explanatory right there.
Oh.
Every knee will bow. And that's why we're here. All right. Now, we was talking about when you get, let's go to Acts 2. This one more with Jesus' name, then we'll talk about the comforter. Just to keep your heads up. Everybody knows the comforter, how the comforter swinging. Acts 2. Who the Lord gonna send in his name. That's why you don't get baptized in the Son, the Father, and the Holy Ghost. Or the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. But the Father's name is what?
Jesus'
name. Jesus' name is what?
Jesus.
And you know, the angel come in whose name?
Jesus.
Oh, so that Trinity stuff out the door. You know what I mean? That's why we're doing this. Acts 19, my bad, man. Acts 19, verse 2. 2-5. Go ahead, 2-5.
He said unto them, have you received the Holy Ghost since ye believe? And they said unto him, we have not so much as heard whether there be any Holy Ghost.
So you know, once they thought they was in the truth, the power come to them and say, hey man, have y'all received the Holy Ghost? That's that comforter that's coming. You understand? So he said, have y'all received the Holy Ghost yet? And look what he said, go ahead.
And he said unto them, unto what then were you baptized? They said, unto John's baptism.
Hey, we know John is temporary. It's almost like a prophet like unto me, Moses to Jesus.
Right.
John was like to Jesus too, wasn't he?
Yes, sir.
So he was like, hey, y'all ain't received the Holy Ghost? Nah, what were y'all baptized? Unto John's baptism. But see, this is what John came with. Go ahead.
Then said Paul, John verily baptized with the baptism of repentance, saying unto the people that they should believe on him which should come after him, that he is on Christ Jesus.
So John's baptism was repentance.
Yes, sir.
But Jesus come with the blood.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, you know what I mean? So, okay, so that's why he said, have y'all received the Holy Ghost? Then look what he did after this. Go ahead.
When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Oh, now here comes the comfort.
For the
you
name.
Know what I mean? Because John was with repentance. So let's go look at the comfort of John 14 real quick. We're almost done. We can start this. John 14. 15. 15-17. Now, he said, have y'all been baptized yet? Have y'all seen the Holy Ghost yet? Has the Holy Ghost come down on y'all? No, not yet. We got the John baptism. You know what I mean? So after he baptized, here come the Holy Ghost, ain't
right.
If you read the next verse, it was jumping down, up and down on them, and they was prophesying, right? All right, go ahead, 15.
If you love me, keep my command.
Everybody know that, yes, sir.
And I will pray the Father that he shall give you another comfort, that he may abide with you forever.
So when y'all go under this water, your knowledge gonna increase.
Mm-hmm.
This is for them to believe and know the truth. Understand what I'm saying? So once you get baptized in there, your knowledge gonna increase because the Lord gonna send you the comfort that's gonna be by you all your time and help you learn more and give you more knowledge on everything. Go ahead.
Even the Spirit of truth.
Yes, sir.
Whom the world cannot receive because it seeth him not.
You don't see him.
Neither knoweth him. But you know him.
Yeah, you know him.
For he dwelleth with you and shall be in you.
Yeah, jump to 26.
26. But the comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name,
yes, sir,
he shall teach you all things.
He's gonna teach you all things.
And bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you.
See what I'm saying? So that's why it's so important. So this is the covenant. You know what I mean? You can't have one without the other. You know what I mean? You got to keep the holy hot days. You got the Sabbath day. I mean, you got the feast days. You know what I'm saying? Baptism is part of the covenant. If you can't have one without the other. You know what I mean? That's what they teach in Sunday. You can do this and do that. But this is the part of the covenant. You can't have one without the other. And baptism is one of these. So that's what we're going to do. Thank the Lord. We're going to baptize. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 baptisms today. Let's pray. All right, let's boy, y'all stand up. We're going to face these. We're going to pray it out, and we're going to do the baptism. Yeah, we're going to Matthew again today.
Father,
which art in heaven.
Hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy kingdom come. I will be done on the earth.
I will be done on the earth.
As it is in heaven.
As it is in heaven.
Give us this day.
Give us this day.
Our daily bread.
Our daily bread.
And forgive us our debts.
Forgive us our debts.
As we forgive our debtors.
As we forgive our debtors.
And lead us not.
Lead us not.
Into temptation. But
deliver us
from evil. For thou
is the kingdom.
And the power.
And the glory.
Forever.
Forever.
Amen.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Amen.
Him as your new disciple. And we ask, Father, hold up, my fault. Wiggins? What's your last name?
Wiggins?
With a WGG?
Yeah, okay.
Great mercy, Father, we bring to you William Wiggins as a living sacrifice. Father, we ask that you accept him as your new disciple. We baptize him in thy son's name, beloved Jesus, for the remission of his past sins.
Come on up, Wiggins.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Joe?
Yeah.
All right. My bad. It won't always be pretty, but it's good.
Amen.
Woo, woo, woo.
Yes, sir.
You better do this before long.
It's all right, brother. You're doing great, Joe.
We baptize her in the name of thy beloved son, Jesus, for the remission of her past sins.
Amen.
Amen.